Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I was reading all the comments from my previous video, the feminine hygiene tips video, and I'm so glad that the video was helpful for so many of you guys out there. And I will be filming a part two because there are some things that I didn't go over, like shaving and stuff like that. So yes, part two coming really soon. From reading my comments, I also noticed that I've been getting some new subscribers that don't know me well. So first, I wanted to introduce you guys to my kids. 연우, 선우.
Hi. Oh, hello.
Hi. Yes, they're my boys. They're playing with their dad right now while I'm filming. Okay, so today I wanted to talk about sensitive skin. Things that you should avoid if you have sensitive skin. And if you're not sure if you have sensitive skin or not, you probably do if your skin reacts whenever you try certain like products. Your face is always like itchy or burning or red. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of you guys out there that's watching this that's similar to me. Here are my list of things to avoid if you have sensitive skin. Number one, if you're testing out a new skincare product, you should always test it out on a small portion of your face instead of applying it on your entire face because you never know if your skin will react to a certain chemical that's in that product. And if you test it out on a small area and it seems fine, then you can maybe try to go ahead and use it on your entire face. If you do react to it, make sure you note it down and see what chemicals and what things are in that product. So for future reference, like whenever you're looking for another skincare product, you know what things to avoid. Second thing is try to avoid makeup products and skincare products that has a very strong fragrance because like the chemicals and the fragrance can actually irritate your skin. Whenever I'm shopping for products, I try to look for like makeup, like foundations that are oil-free and no fragrance. Also for skincare, I try to look for no fragrance. Third thing is to avoid harsh exfoliators. Like for the face, try to avoid the ones with the harsh like scrubs. Or even like tiny beads because even those tiny beads can also irritate your skin. So I try to go for the very gentle exfoliating gels that don't contain any of the beads inside because if you have sensitive skin and you use that, that could actually irritate the skin and cause like rashes and redness and dryness. There might be some people that get like rashes and like bumps on their body and their neck but not on their face, and that might be because your laundry detergent, your skin might react to that detergent, so you should try changing out your detergent and see if your skin gets any better. When I first moved to Korea, I tried this one detergent and I was getting like bumps everywhere, like on my leg and my back, and I was like, what is this? And then my cousin was like, I think it's your detergent, you need to change it. So as soon as I changed it, it got so much better. Also your shampoo, even if the shampoo works great for you, like your hair, it might react to your body. My neck area and wherever my hair touches, it like breaks out and I get itchy. So be careful with those. Also wanted to point out, make sure that you don't overuse a product. You might think that your skin is like super sensitive, but it can be because you're overusing a product. And that happens to me when I overuse a cleanser and a toner. Those are the two main things for me. So I tried to figure things out and I made my skincare routine that works for me. And like I mentioned in my previous video, I did switch to cleanser one time a day at night, and then in the morning I just washed my face with water, and that helped so much. My face is less dry and irritated. So now I only go for like gentle hydrating toners. The one that I'm using right now, the one from Hera, I think that works so great for me because my skin works so well with hyaluronic acid. So now even when I'm buying like other skincare products like face masks, I always look for the keyword hyaluronic acid. And the face mask is what I wanted to talk about next. For me, for people that have sensitive skin, like certain masks can actually break you out, cause irritation and itchiness. So you also have to be careful with your masks. But if you find the right one that works best for you, it will be very beneficial to use it. Your skin goes through a lot during the day, so at the end of the day, if you just put a mask on, it can help with like calming, with the redness, and like hydrated. A lot of other skincare benefits, so try to find your perfect masks. Okay guys, so that was all the tips and advices that I wanted to share with you guys for those that have sensitive skin. I'm planning to do like makeup beauty tips for oily skin and makeup beauty tips for dry skin. It will be like two different videos. So please let me know in the comments which skin type that you have. And like I mentioned, I'll also have the feminine part two for you guys coming. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe so you'll be notified when I have a new video up. And I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys!